And would you take the mic over, please?
Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum
assalam. Sir, if somebody wants to work as a volunteer in your hospital, would you welcome that?
Absolutely. Absolutely. The thing is that the mechanics to doing something like this becomes very difficult because of the timing and when you want to do it and for how long you want to do it. And maybe you may not find this the circumstances, atmosphere so conducive, because in Pakistan it's difficult to find a doctor who lives in the city for him to go with his doctor wife and live in a village and then go to the hospital for almost for every day. Even in Pakistan it's very difficult. Lest you would find somebody in the UK, you know, to come there and live in those environments, you know, whereby the facilities are less. That's what I mean. The facilities are not conducive to the kind of facilities you people are used to. You know, sometimes the electricity goes away. Sometimes you don't have the car over there. You know, sometimes there is a dearth of water over there sometimes. So these are the things that come in between. That's why the modalities of doing something like this becomes very difficult. Having said that, even then, doctors do come, nurses do come. So who is here, he can plan something like this for you people, if ever you have a
plan. Now,
one more question.
Sorry, just
one. Very brief. I agree with Sister Siman that elderly ladies should be advised.
Yes, sir.
And I go slightly bit further, that you create a section in your organization for advising them for birth control, because there is an overpopulation already, and if elderly women, not young, but elderly women are advised for birth control, that's all.
I personally feel that elderly gentlemen should also be advised. Yeah. actually, in our part of the society, हमारे मुल्क में तो कहते हैं कि मर्दों को आफत आई है। उन बिचारों का क्या कसूर है?
आपने बिल्कुल सही बात की है।
है ना जी?
Thank you. So, we need to take one last question. Dinner is waiting to be served. And I'm going to ask our very dear brother, Saif Ahmed. Brother Saif Ahmed has also worked as a consultant for Muslim charity, and he's also the former CEO of Muslim
Aid. Nice to meet you, sir. Nice to
meet
you.
I think one question came to you,
Brother
Junaid, I'm sure, but obviously that you avoided the answer, whether it is preferable to build hospitals and mosques and madrasas. I just give you a stark statistics. In 2008, Muslim population was just about 20% of the world population, and it took the share of 88% of the maternal death across the world. More than four times than its proportion. That means the total number of women death at childbirth in 2008 is approximately 500,000, slightly more, and Muslim community contributed 88% of this death. And I understand many theologians who could be here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that saving the life of one human being is as if saving the life of the entire humanity.
Yes.
So building a mosque can give provision of 100, 200, 1,000, but not saving the life of the entire creation. So that's the comparison, and I'm not giving any fatwa. So I think Muslim charity has understood the seriousness of this issue, and although it's a small charity, relatively, but it has taken a historic role, for which I think the time will tell over a longer period what's the impact of it.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
I'm going to have to seize the question at this point. Dinner is waiting to be served, but I just want a few minutes. I can't sit next to you and not ask you to sing us a few lines.
Oh, my gosh.
Let's give him a round of applause for that.
I would love to. And before I read, thank you very much to all of you. I just met Mr. Martin Shaw. Thank you very much for coming in, sir. Brother Saif, thank you very much. Always a pleasure meeting you. Salim Bhai, thank you very much. You're always very kind, and I've been seeing you for a long time. My hair has gone gray, but yours is still black. I don't know how. And all my friends and sisters, thank you very much for being here. Please give yourself a wonderful round of applause.
Before you start, there's a small section of this audience who are very respected. Ulama from the Bangladeshi community are here.
MashaAllah.
So a couple of lines in Bangla as well.
Oh,
not many of you would know, but I'm Bangladeshi. But the Junaid Jamshed sings Bangla in a way that not even a Bangladeshi could sing. SubhanAllah.
Nabi mar parashmani Nabi mar shonar khoni singing. So he gave those meanings, some words. My dear Martin, I apologize, you know, that unfortunately you do not understand what I'm singing. Jo bhi lega mere nabi ka naam, jo bhi lega pyare nabi ka naam, ucha hoga sari duniya mein na, uchi hogi sari duniya mein shaan, jo bhi lega mere nabi ka naam, dil se lega pyare nabi hoga sare alam mein na, unchi hogi is duniya mein shaan, jo bhi lega
jazakallah khan. Let's hear it for the brother. Well, brothers and sisters, this isn't the end of it. This is just the beginning of the night. We're going to be serving some food now. And then straight after that, myself and Brother Junaid Jamshed will be back on stage to conduct some of the more important things for tonight, inshallah. So enjoy the meal. Take the opportunity to take photographs with Brother Junaid Jamshed and come and have a chat with him, inshallah. Photographs with me are completely free. If anybody wants any, so please do. So enjoy the evening. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum.